Mr. Tanjit, very quickly, last question from you. Countries, smaller economies like Indonesia, Taiwan, the Philippines, how are they faring in handling this very complicated situation?
Their health infrastructure isn't up to it, and quite frankly, neither the finances. This week, the G20 will be meeting virtually. It's very important that these countries, who represent 90% of the world's GDP, take a leadership position, not only to take care of their own problems, but to remember that there's a whole world out there and that they have a responsibility to act it. And it's not just responsibility. If they fail to do this disease and the economic consequences could go on for a much longer period and do more damage, not only to the world's economy, but their own. Easing lending is at a time when you don't have people buying, all the money you can borrow is just putting you further into debt. So that's one of the things that China is very aware of. The UK is also doing some helicopter money. They're trying to push money. They say they're going to cover anybody who is out because of the COVID-19. So that's one way of keeping consumption somewhat on a steady footing. But the fact is, all of these shops everywhere is closed, sporting events, etc. This is a huge impact to economies that are really about 80% choice. It's not necessity. About 20% of Britain's and US advanced countries, their GDP, 20% goes to necessities. The rest is just the things that we want. And if they're not buying that has a very serious effect on the economy.